I think it was some Tai Chi in the small frame, but Tai Chi was how we go.
When you're doing a low movement in the small frame level, this is your base. And as a consequence of that, there's not much difference, or there's no difference in what your feet are doing. Your hands change slightly from the low movements because it's your hands mainly that make the form into small frame form. Apart from the obvious, when you're just taking little steps like that for your crushed and twisted and so on. Basically, the face stays the same because that's the yang part and the hands and the yin part, although everything's interrelated. So we got up to all the low moves, called the bending backwards moves. When we got up to the reverse chi move, we're going to go into the low moves now. So when you took that reverse chi move, that's the only one of these movements where you take a single grip step instead of the normal bow stance. So in your training, I think I was doing it that direction, but don't worry, I won't just do it this direction anymore. So when you come to this move here, you've come here, okay. You take a long, you just go down a little bit further, take a longer step in order to get like a single grip step for that move. So it's a long, see how it's a longer step. That enables you to get down without pushing the front foot out. And that should be the same with your single grip as well. With all of these squatting movements, I think I've explained to you before, think of this part of your body just sitting straight down on the ground. Remember, it was invented by people with shorter legs than a normal Western person, and it was much easier for them to squat down and do these low squatting movements. So, but if you think of, so you've still got to turn your left foot out. You can shuffle if you wish. If you can't get that long step, obviously, can't get that long step then without going like this. It must be just a step, so you've got to drop down a little lower, and so you get a little, it's a skinnier step as well, so you can get longer. If you can't get that, then you're going to have to go 1, 2, 3 in order to get down lower. However, if you can get that longer step, you should be able to just turn that foot out from here, and then your heel pushes out. But you see, squat down, the weight goes onto your right, left leg. So as you come back, just think about that, squatting down. Maybe I'll deal with it, because that's how we'll be doing it. This is the next module. We're going from here, all right? We just all do it together. We'll do this whole section up until that move. Of course, it helps if you're doing angle transform. still get it all together, and I'll explain some of the minor differences. Let's go from here again. Difference is when I was on the